Has decided Bryn's speech are inflicted on her boyfriend back in 2018, killing him. Last week, she escaped jail time in sentencing as a judge cited cannabis-induced psychosis as the reason, saying she had no control over her actions. So, what exactly is cannabis-induced psychosis? For answers about all of that, we turn to Dr. Delani Gunawardena, an internal medicine physician and addiction medicine specialist with Kaiser Permanente Sacramento. Doctor, good morning to you.
Good morning.
So in this murder of Chad O'Malley in Ventura County, Bryn Spreacher describes taking a few hits off a bong with her boyfriend Chad before attacking him 6 years ago. With just a few hits, how do we get to psychosis? How is cannabis-induced psychosis different from just getting high? You know, those who choose to smoke kind of want, expect to not feel like themselves.
A good question. I wasn't involved directly in the case, but I can speak a little bit about some of the risks of cannabis use, including the risk of psychosis. So just to take a step back, psychosis is a set of symptoms that refers to someone just having trouble distinguishing between what is real and what is not real, and can include hallucinations, paranoia, and delusions. The cause of psychosis is complex and involves multiple factors, but we have an understanding now that cannabis can trigger psychotic symptoms. Sometimes they are self-limited and resolve once marijuana is out of their system. And then other times that episode can, trigger a psychotic disorder like schizophrenia.
So how common is this kind of psychosis? Could someone smoke regularly for years even and then never get there while somebody else does it once or twice and ends up in a psychotic sort of state?
Yeah, it's a great question, and it's really hard to know the answer to that because, as I mentioned, the relationship is between cannabis and other factors, and psychosis is complex. And so exactly as you said, you know, someone may use cannabis regularly and never experience these kinds of complications, and other people, especially if they have risk factors for it. So, you know, we have a better understanding now that, you know, if someone is younger, so a younger adult, or is using a high potency product, for example, or has other risk factors like a genetic predisposition for mental health problems, those all could increase one's risk of experiencing psychosis from their cannabis use.
Okay, now when it comes to the effects of marijuana, society just kind of laughs it off, that users get hungry and really mellow. But even if your reaction doesn't rise to the level of psychosis, there can be some serious bodily impacts, a faster heart rate, nausea and vomiting, changes in blood pressure, right?
Yes, that's true. And so a lot of people use cannabis because it, you know, might promote a sense of relaxation. They might experience some euphoric effects from it, but it is also quite common that people might notice, worsening of anxiety or paranoid thoughts that don't quite reach the level of acute psychosis, but are still bothersome. And then, as you mentioned, it can have other negative health consequences as well. So, you know, for example, a syndrome that results in excessive vomiting. If people are smoking it, it can cause respiratory issues. And then also there can be the development of cannabis use disorder, which is where people lose control over their cannabis use and continue to use it in spite of the fact that it's causing problems in their life.
All righty, so those are all very big concerns. Now, getting help for this can be a challenge if your insurance doesn't cover treatment for substance use disorders or you have Medi-Cal. In Sacramento County, you can find resources by calling 916-874-9754 or toll-free 1-888-881-4881. But, doctor, the most important thing, though, is to just get started, right? Reach out for help.
Yeah, I would say that's really the takeaway message. If you're experiencing any complications from your cannabis use, there is support for you. And you can start with reaching out to your regular healthcare provider. But as you mentioned, if you don't have a regular healthcare provider, or if you're a Medi-Cal beneficiary, or otherwise don't have insurance that covers treatment, you can reach out to the county, Sacramento County. And then, of course, if you're a Kaiser member, we have a comprehensive program that accepts walk-ins without any kind of referral. So there is treatment available for people who need support.
All righty, doctor. Thank you so much for joining us this morning to sort of explain what just really threw a lot of people off last week, talking about cannabis-induced psychosis and trying to kind of parse that out from just a regular high. We appreciate your insight.
Thank you.